Children, in this video, I am going to explain question number 1, first part of exercise 5.2 of the chapter Arithmetic Progression. Okay, in this question, first question, you have been given some certain things. You have been given A, you are given D, you are given N, and you have to find AN. This is the first part of question number 1. A, D, N are given to you and you are supposed to find AN. This is for you a very simple question. You will straight away put the formula of AN and then you will put all these three values in the formula and you will get AN as 28. Okay, this is AN. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1D. In the last video, I told you how to derive this formula. And the formula for finding AN is A plus N minus 1D. After that, you just have to put all these values in this formula. A is 7, D is 3, and N is 8. After putting these values, you will be able to find the answer, and which is 28. Now, children, here I want to make one thing very clear. See, simply because we know the formula doesn't mean that you have to use this formula. What is the meaning of this? You can do this question in simple way also. You are given N is equal to 8. You must understand the meaning of all these things, all these terms. A is equal to 7. A means the first term is 7. D is equal to 3. D means the common difference is 3. N is equal to 8. When some AP is written like this, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and so on, then let us talk about this term 5. This is coming at third number. So here N for this term, N is 3 because it is at number 3. So number of this term is 3 and AN means the term itself. So here AN is 5. Okay, AN means what term is there in that number and N means a number. At number 3, which term is there? Number 3, term is 5. Okay, you must know the meaning of N and AN, what this signifies. Okay, now children, I'm just going to tell you that when you know N, you know you have to find 8th term. N8 means you have to find 8th term. So, in the last video, you learned how to derive this formula. There you saw a certain pattern. You saw that when we are finding A1, it is simply A. A2 is A plus D. A3 is A plus 2D. A4 is A plus 3D. So when you know you have to find 8th term, that means you know ki AN means A8 you have to find and A8 means A plus 7D. Straight away I have written this, ki A8 means A plus 7D. And then you can put the values here to find the value of A8 as 28. Here also we got 28 and here also 28. It is your choice. If you want to use the formula, you may use the formula. But if you want to do it directly, you can do it directly also. Directly you can do only when you know N. If you know what is N, that means you know which number term you have to find and then you can find it directly also without using the formula. Okay,